The camp of the Sultan of Sulu is holding a press conference. Let's listen in.
Before the fire erupted, the first shot was fired by the Malaysian police commando. We are on our way to meet the ambassador of Malaysia. Unfortunately, when the first shot was fired upon by the Malaysian police commando to the Royal Security Force, the Sultan of Sulu recalled us and asked us to inform the Malaysian officials that we cannot be in the position anymore to talk with them regarding any negotiations for that matter. However, I would like to emphasize that this does not mean that the Sultanate of Sulu is closing the doors for negotiation.
Has the Philippine government initiated any contact with the Kiram side?
Except that we heard many, various statements coming from the spokesman of Malacañang.
Formally and officially, have they contacted the family?
Not yet.
So has there been any humanitarian aid reaching your people in Sabah?
Not yet. That's the problem that is confronting us now. So we appeal to the media to kindly help us along this line in order to present or to invite the attentions of concerned agencies so that humanitarian assistance can reach the group of Datu Raja Muda who are right now holed up and condoned by the Malaysian police commando.
Government has not initiated talks with you. Will your side take the initiative to reach out to the government, Philippine government?
We have announced many times. What is being needed is let us talk. Let us sit down. Come up with mechanism in resolving the issue.
Sir, yung 10 casualties, still 10 pa rin, sir?
10 pa rin, wala pang increase. Doon sa 10 namatay, isa ang babae at 4 ang injured.
So ibig sabihin po, hindi na po wala ng striking, wala nang nangyari,
tigil na muna. In war, it may titigil ilan oras tapos bakbakan naman yan. In other words, each side is only finding a better way to, you know, to go with the enemy.
Sir, yung 4, sir, kamusta sila?
Hindi ho natin alam, but definitely siguro walang gamot.
Do you think, sir, the operations will resume when night falls? When
That's the favorite subject of these people if it is nightfall.
Sir, yung pag-alis nila Sultan Kiram ngayon has nothing to do with this. It's just a personal engagement where they will be talking to somebody very special that could help them or the situation.
I was told by the wife that he's going to meet a relative. That's all.
Mm-hmm. Sir, how do you feel now that Malacañang is not making any, the president is not making any statements?
Hopefully that this is not the sign Malacañang is abandoning the archipelago of Sulu.
Indications that the other side is preparing for an attack by nightfall?
Well, according to reliable source, that Malaysia will use its military might to attack the Raja Muda in view of big casualties that they suffered during the fight today. These numbers is texted from Kuala Lumpur. I'm sorry to name names, but this is from the KL officials informing their friends here in Manila and also informing us that that number of casualties of the Malaysian police commando now compelled the military officials of Malaysia to launch another attack against Datu Raja Muda.
Sir, what is your report? How many died on their side?
Well, according to this text message from Kuala Lumpur, there are 69.
69.
Yeah, it's here. 69.
Dead, sir. Dead.
Dead.
From the Malaysian side?
From the Malaysian side. Ito ang text.
Sir, hindi meron ng 69 dead. Ano yun?
Ha? Huh?
69 dead, ano? Kalino lang po.
Sir, without revealing your reliable source, can you at least characterize your source? Is this from the military? Is this from...
From a friend of Kuala Lumpur officials. Tuan, my friend in Kuala Lumpur called me and said many casualties of Malaysian police. He said better augment Royal Army. This is the text message. In the 69, nagkamali ko, I'm sorry. But number of one, meron namatay. May namatay. Hindi, I'm
there
sorry.
There 69 wounded, among them dead, ganon?
Casualty. Casualty, siguro died and wounded.
So, sir, following this incident today, will you be sending augmentation force, reinforcement?
No. Sultan Jamalul Kiram III will never do that. Otherwise, that will escalate the conflict.
Sir, just questions. There have been reports, at least been talked about, that you have also, Ms. Wari and the MNLF are also behind the decision, in fact, that they were, encouraged to go to Sabah and try to take over this area. They said that Ms. Wari and Ms. Group are behind
No. We completely deny that. We have said from the beginning, Jamila, that the ally of the Sultanate of Sulu, number one, the Almighty God. Number two, historical truth. Number three, the media. Number four, the Sambayanang Pilipino. And the other is government officials who sympathize because of the Sultanate of Sulu.
President Aquino in his speech was also kind of implying that somebody also funded the group.
Well,
some local politicians, in fact, who have their own vested interests, and they said that they have, in fact, exploited. Well, he didn't say that, but some talks that they said your struggle has, in a way, been exploited by some groups who have vested interests.
No, Jamila. Because if it is so, then I should not be taking motorcycle from the jeepney from the jeepney, what how do you call that, parking area to the house of the Raja Muda. And from my house I am taking LRT. From LRT I'm taking a ride through commuting.
But also another question is, there many are asking why now?
Well, why now?
Why not before?
Well, if that is good, because why now? I'm also throwing the question: why did our government relegated the Sabah issue into the back burner? That's the answer. Why now? That's the answer, Jamila. Why now? The answer to that why now? Why also the government relegated the Sabah issue to the back burner? In fact, Jamila, we have written a letter to the president, which is the subject of the president's focus, president's statement, that it is true. How do you say that? Laws by bureaucratic.
Sir, you were supposed to meet with the Malaysian ambassador today. This did not happen. So, ibig sabihin, may open lines kayo. Did you get to ask him bakit inassault?
Hindi na. Because ang sinabi na lang namin, Mr. Your Excellency, we sought your kind understanding we have to return back on advice of Sultan Jamalul Kiram III in view of the situation now going on in the area of Datu Raja Agbimuddin.
How did he respond, sir?
Well, he said, thank you very much for the kind statement.
You have messages now, you have appeals now for the Malaysian government. Don't you want to rely directly to him now?
Well, if Malaysia is really concerned about the welfare of its military, like the question also can be thrown, if the Sultan of Sulu is concerned of his royal security forces, Then in order to put an end to this, let us talk about the Sabah issue.
Is there any other heir or member of the family that are not with this decision to go to, Laha Datu is now having standing there?
The decision of Datu Raja Muda was made twice. It was only the last time that the Sultan of Sulu agreed Raja Muda to go to Malaysia. However, with a specific instruction, I will only allow you if you go there to live in peace, which the Datu Raja Muda said yes.
Okay, so going back to the communications with the Malaysian ambassador, you have direct contact with him now, and you have concerns, the possible attack tonight, the food blockade, and many other issues. Can you not relay it to him directly now so that he can find a solution to it?
Well, I think the media is enough to help us to tell the people and the world, and the Filipino people and the world about that question. We have announced this since this day six, appealing for the kind consideration of Malaysia to lift the food blockade. But what Malaysia did, our appeal fell into their deep ear.
You don't want to say it to him directly, sir?
Yes.
You don't want to say it to him directly?
They don't want, because to them, by talking to the Sultan of Sulu, ang sa kanila, recognition of the Sultan of Sulu, yun ang laging sinasabi nila.
So you've also mentioned, this was earlier last week when you mentioned that one of the reasons why you decided to go is because you felt that you were sidelined during the peace negotiations. Just a question, because we've been told also that you were in fact consulted, or at least your group has been consulted, but during the consultation there were no objections raised at that time.
No, I'm sorry. We cannot equate Sabah issue to the framework argument. That is a different thing. Why? Because the Sultanate of Sulu, if we recall history, has been fighting for so many years. And it wants its ancestral kingdom, although the Sultanate of Sulu is already incapacitated of its international person, capable of asserting sovereign rights, but still, the Sultan of Sulu wanted peace to reign in its ancestral kingdom. We have been tired fighting. The only reason why we go there is because we want to show to the Malaysian government our desire to live in peace in that area, because the Sultanate of Sulu firmly believe, not going to assert, but firmly believe that Sabah belongs to us. Not when I say us, the entire Filipino people.
Gine-recognize po sa nangyaring standoff, ganun po katotol na nagkaroon ng harassment sa mga civilian Filipino doon sa Malaysia?
Opo, kararating lang ng text message ng kapatid at pamangkin ni Sultan na kanila hong hinihingi paabot sa inyo na tulungan sila para malaman ng buong sambayan ng Filipino.
Ganun po karami Filipino yung naharas ngayon doon?
Accordingly, nearly 100 are being rounded up and brought to the police station.
Sampun lugar?
Sa Sampuna.
Manayo po ba dito kay Dato yun?
Mga about 200 kilometers, I think.
Okay.
Not yet, but this announcement is enough to convince Malaysia if Malaysia really wants the truth to be found out.
That was the press conference of the camp of the Sultan of Sulu. The Sultan's spokesman reiterated their claim that 10 of their followers were killed, including a woman, and 4 were hurt in the assault by Malaysian forces in Sabah. Kiram spokesman Abraham Ijirani also claims that dozens of Malaysian policemen were either hurt or killed in the clash. The Malaysian embassy had earlier reported that 2 Malaysian policemen died and another person was killed in the assault in Laha Datu, where the Sulu Sultan's followers had been holed up for nearly 3 weeks now. Ijirani again appealed to Malaysia to discuss with them their territorial role.